Hello everyone, I'm Jessica, and today I'm here to give you the mid-year book freakout tag. I have done this video the last 2 years. I will link those in the description box below. The original creator's video is no longer accessible, but it was created by Chammy, and I will put the questions in the description box below as well in case you're interested in doing this video. So essentially, it's just middle of the year, books you've read, books you want to read. Let's get to it. Question one, best book that you've read so far this year. So I did a check, and the only book that I've read this year that had a 4.75 stars that was not a sequel, because that is a follow-up question, is The Kiss of Deception by Mary E. Pearson. So I give this a 4.75 out of 5 stars. And if you're interested in my full thoughts on any of these, I will link my Goodreads review in the description box below for all of these. Along with timestamps, the next question is best sequel you've read so far this year. So for me, there were 4 books that I read that were sequels that had a 4.75 rating. So because none of them are technically better than the other, I will list all 4 of those for you. They are Blood Witch by Susan Dennard. This is the 3rd book in the Witchland series. Queen of Air and Darkness by Cassie Clare. This is the 3rd and final book in the Darkest Artifices series. The Vanishing Stair by Maureen Johnson. This is the 2nd book in the Truly Devious series. And because I love her so much, Strange and Ever After, the 3rd book and 3rd and final book in the Something Strange and Deadly series by Susan Dennard. Question 3. New release that you haven't read but want to. The one that was glaringly obvious to me when I was looking at my small collection of new releases that I have this year was The Red Scrolls of Magic by Cassie Clare and Wesley Chu. This is the 1st book in The Eldest Curses, and it's a Cassie Clare book, so of course I want to read it. Most anticipated releases for the remainder of the year. I have 3. They are Capturing the Devil, which is the final book in the Stalking Jack the Ripper series by Carrie Maniscalco. Queen of Nothing, which is the 3rd book in the Cruel Prince series by Holly Black, which I believe is actually the Folk of the Air series, but whatever. And the 3rd is The Tyrant's Tomb, which is the 4th book in the Trials of Apollo series by Rick Riordan. 5. Your biggest disappointment. For me, that was The Lost Coast by Amy Rose Capetta. So much hype for this book and so little like for this book. I have a full review video. I'll link that in the description box below, as well as in the cards if you want to check out why it didn't really work for me, but why I also see why it worked for so many people. 6. Your biggest surprise. For me, that was What the Dead Want by Nora Olsen. The reason why this was the biggest surprise is not because I didn't think I was going to enjoy it, because I don't buy books that I don't think I'm going to enjoy, because that just seems really dumb. I enjoyed it. It went in a direction that I was not expecting it to. It had a very different theme than I was expecting. I enjoyed it, but it wasn't what I was expecting, so it was definitely a very big surprise. I read this for a readathon. I can't remember which one at this moment in time, but I will link that readathon in the description box below so you can see like my in-the-moment thoughts about this book, because I had a lot of them. Favorite new author, either new to you or a debut. And for me, that was Mary E. Pearson. I have only read this one book, so that may come or go, but I did really enjoy this book. I really love what she did with her characters and her plot, so I am very looking forward to the rest of the series. Also, I'm currently reading a book by CeCe Hunter called This Heart of Mine. Yeah, I'm like 30% into that book, and I can already tell you that whether I love the plot of that or not, I absolutely love CeCe Hunter's writing. It is beautiful. It is some of the best writing that I've ever read in my entire life. Highly, highly enjoying that. So, like I said, that's my current read, so I can't say that it's like my new favorite author because I haven't finished the book yet, but I have a feeling that if this question came up a month from now, yeah, that'd be the answer. Newest fictional crush, Daniel from the Something Strange and Deadly series, is Victorian. He is not a gentleman, ladies. He is rough and tumble, and he loves his girl because she's different from everyone else. Not like, and that like she's not like other girls thing, but just like, she's weird and he likes it. So, dear gods, whichever of you are listening, please bring me a man like Daniel. I would greatly appreciate that. Thank you. Newest favorite character, Stevie from Truly Devious. So I read both of these books this year. I really love Stevie. She is a very interesting character. She has some anxiety issues, which are very realistic. She has, the way she looks at the world is so interesting. I really love that about the first book. Like, some people don't like it, but for me it was like, this girl is weird and quirky and I like it. Again, not in a she's not like other girls type of manner, but just like an interesting way. So I really enjoyed this book. I really enjoy Stevie, and she is probably my favorite character that I've read this year, which is why she was the answer for the question. Duh. It's coming back for a third time, guys, so here we go. Book that made you cry. For that, I have Strange and Ever After by Susan Dennard. This is the 3rd book in the Darkness, Strange and Lovely series. I didn't cry. I sobbed. Like, snot running down my face, couldn't stop crying, sobbed during the last 30% of this book. It was gut-wrenching, heart-wrenching, so fucking sad. So, like, it pulled me out of my world in a way that I haven't experienced in a really long time. Like, we're talking, made me think and made me be so speechless, like, epilogue of Clockwork Princess. Like, it just absolutely destroyed me to the point that I was, like, I was live tweeting my feelings on Twitter and actually got a comment from Susan. We had like a little bit of a chat about how the ending is hit or miss with people. I'll link that chat in the description box below. Basically about how some people, especially if it's like older teens and adults, really appreciate the ending, but like younger teens are like, this is dumb. So yeah, it destroyed me. Like, it absolutely destroyed me. Like, I still, when I was thinking about what I wanted to say about this book, sitting at the desk, and right now, I was crying thinking about it. Like, it was one of the hardest things I've ever had to read in my life. And, it was rough. It was real rough. Yeah. Yeah. On a lighter note, book that made you happy, Song of the Dryad by Natalia Lee. Natalia Lee is a fellow authortuber, and I will link her channel in the description box below. I loved this book. It was so whimsy, so fun. It was full of fairies, different types of fae that you don't really see a lot in common fae type books, which I love. It was very elemental, very, I don't want to say witchy because there's no witches, but it is, has like, you know, gemstones and things like that. So it was very interesting. Was there witches in this book? There is a coven in this book. I just lied to you. Oh, guys, I'm just, whew, it's late. And I'm hot. It's like 900 degrees in here. Anyway, this book was so, so good. So, so fun. So whimsical. I absolutely love it. I have... Natalia's not my friend. Like, not like I don't like her and she hates me, but like I don't know her personally. But I still want her to let me know if like there's gonna be like another book that has to do with the end of this book. Because like this story's wrapped up nice and neat, but there was a thing that happened at the end of this one that really made me hope that there's gonna be a book in the future that has to do with the end of what happened here, because it was fucking amazing. Yeah, I really enjoyed this book. 12, most beautiful book you've either bought or received this year. For me, because I haven't bought a lot of books this year, really what I'm enjoying is Zodiac Star Force by Kevin Panetta, Paulina Ganusho, and Sarah Stern. This is the second volume, Cries of the Fire Prince. I showed some pictures when I was doing this before, but basically just the fucking artwork in this book. Yeah, the artwork in this is just absolutely brilliant and amazing, and I absolutely love it. It is one of my, I mean, I love the story itself, but definitely one of my favorite things about this book is the artwork. And so the last question, hopefully before my camera dies, is what books do you need to read by the end of the year? I started the year with a list of 10 authors that I want to read before the end of the year, and I still have 6 of those. And they are Alexander Bracken, Maria Liu, Victoria Schwab, or V.E. Schwab, whichever, Neil Schusterman, Saba Tahir, and Lainey Taylor. So those 6 I still need to read before the end of the year. I also have like some most anticipated releases of the year to go as well, but those aren't out yet, so I can't really like control that. But the ones that I already own books of, I need to read. So that's why I have those on a list. Okay, that was my mid-year book freakout tag with a little bit of extra freak out because my camera has been flashing light at me since I started this thing. Woo, fun times. Okay, anyway, that is all I have for today. I post reading, writing, and book-related videos on Mondays and Wednesdays and bonus videos on the weekends. And during the month of July, I'm going to be posting pretty much 4 times a week, so it's going to be a fun shit show. Hope you are here to watch it. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do, because if you don't, then you'll miss all the fun I have going on in the future. And until then, I'll see you guys next time.